Hendrick Regional Blood Center is in need of all blood types, and you can help them save lives. Here to tell us how is Frances Baker. Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you, Stacy.
You are the face of Hendrick Regional Blood Center. I just want you to know that.
I guess I am.
I always think of you when I think of donating blood. That's probably a good thing, though.
That's good.
So the summertime, tell us about donations in the summertime and how they kind of drop.
They drop mainly because we just don't have really big blood drives like we do during the school year. We might go to a couple of high schools a week during the school year where we have in excess 50 to 75 donors. But in the summertime, we just don't have those big blood drives, you know, driving the blood supply. So we're more dependent on people coming to us.
And you're really needing all blood types, not just one specific.
That's right. The whole inventory is low. I wouldn't call it critical, but it will get there quickly if something happens.
And obviously, the need for that blood doesn't drop.
Never stops. Never stops. I've never seen a day when we didn't have an order for blood. I mean, typically, we ship out between 30 and 60 units a day.
Wow. And, you know, I've just gave blood for the Guns and Hoses blood drive. Was so excited my iron was high enough. Tell everyone out there really how easy and quick it is to go give blood.
Well, it is, and I wouldn't say Guns and Hoses was quick because people had to wait, but most of the time it takes 30 minutes is all, and it's very easy. We try to make it as easy as possible, get you in and out, and I always say that hour you spend giving blood could give someone else a lifetime, so it's an hour well spent.
And I think you do, I think you send something to that donor if they do save a life, correct?
We do. We send them a text message about 45 days after they donate to see how long, we let them know how long we had their blood on the shelf before it was used to save a life and which one of the 17 hospitals we supply blood to that unit actually went to.
I love it. And how often can you give blood? Because I'm ready to give again.
Every 8 weeks.
Okay.
56 days.
And is there anything specific that we should be doing before we come to give blood to make sure we're ready to go and that blood is ready to go?
Just eat a really good meal. And right now, particularly, it's important to be well hydrated. So water is really your best friend before you donate blood and after you donate blood. But make sure you eat.
And then the after process, after you have given blood, what should we be doing to make sure that we are well?
Just make sure you stay on the bus, make sure you feel good, have a snack, have another drink, have another good meal, and try not to go out and do a heavy workout or anything like that. You know, just save that for the next day.
All right, and do we need an appointment to come and donate blood?
No, you don't. We'll get you in and out as quickly as we possibly can.
All right, and tell us what it is like to get that text message saying you saved a life.
Well, it's awesome. I get them too because I donate. And I've heard more people tell me, I was having a bad day or I forgot what I did. And that message reminded me that I did something really awesome. And, you know, hopefully motivates them to do it again because you never know. And I always say, I wish people could be like in the position I'm in where you see people on the other end of that bag, the recipients.
Okay.
So it's a good thing all the way around.
And my producer, Adam, is a very avid blood giver. Love him for that. He's got a great heart. If you would like to donate, you can go to either of their two locations in Abilene or find a blood drive near you. For more information, you can go to HendrickBloodCenter.org.